Hello guys, me Carlos Santos, aka Happy Carlos 957, and welcome to another edition of NASCAR Heat 5 Career Mode. So, we're already in Martinsville already, so here's my discouraging qualifying lap. So, I think we're going to be starting mid-pack because I'm not used to the brake binders as far as stopping and actually letting the car rotate from the middle of the corners. Oh, man. Can't you believe I wrecked in qualifying? Well, at least we'll start forward. You're gonna have to climb up the field from there, so. Yeah. And when you're qualifying the back of the pack, the leaders are gonna catch you and put you a lap down, so. That's very discouraging for me and unacceptable for our high expectations coming into this race. So let's see. Denny Hamlin and Kevin Harvick on the front row. And I believe Joey Keese and David Reagan don't like me, despite the stories of the race being different from what I said. But yeah, those are my rivals right now. Yep, Joey Gase is struggling this weekend, and David Reagan had an engine issue, and Eric Jones failed pre-race inspection, so. So let's see if I can climb up in the field, so. I'm only going to commentate for a few minutes, like 1 to 2 minutes, and then I'll just fast forward to the end of the race because I have family bonding time with my nieces, so yeah, I don't want them up going to my room upstairs interrupting my racing movie projects that I'm doing for you guys in NASCAR Heat 5. So. Well, commentating does mean a lot to me, but unless I have to commentate for a long time, for a long period, then I'll do it, so. It's like the luck of the draw, you know? Like, I would have done this earlier, but yeah, I knew Martinsville and Michigan were gonna be terrible performances, I'm telling you. Like, not much to say. Like, we're gonna be battling against some back markers, you know, so. Oh well. Let's just fast forward to the end of the race.
Stay low, stay low. All right. All clear. Keep it up. That was your best lap ever. Careful, still there. Car outside. Hold your line. Got one inside. All right, clear outside. Inside. Bottom three. Use it if you need it. Got a car high now. Got a car low now. Don't move. Stay high. Got one inside. All right, clear low. All clear. Got a car high now. All clear. Three wide. Clear high. Clear high. Still there. That's the halfway mark. Inside. Clear all around. Inside. Bottom clear. Farther on the inside. All right, you're clear. Got a car low now. Got a car low now. Got one inside. All clear. Hard from the outside. Outside. You're all clear of top. Inside. You're all clear of top. Still there. Hold your line. Got one outside. Hard from the outside. Outside. In you go. Focus. Car there on your outside. Far there on your outside. Got one inside. All right, clear low. Car high, careful. All right, you're clear. All right, clear outside. clear outside. Looking inside now. You're all clear on the bottom. Got one outside. high, stay high. All clear. Got one kicking inside. And full flaps to go. And count five. Still there. Careful, still there.
So we're back. So I tried to show you the end of the race, but I lost footage of it for the Martinsville one. So I was battling Cole Custer for the lucky dog, and I just never got my lap back, and I eventually finished like somewhere in the 20s. So yeah, very disappointing race at Martinsville. So. But the next race after Martinsville is Charlotte, the Coke 600. Like in the previous video, I discussed how I won the race over Ryan Newman. It was a blast, you know. Came from turn 3 and 4 trying to make a move on him, and I drove on the outside of him and got a little bit loose, and I got the win in the number 43 Petty car. I'm telling you, Richard Petty would be smiling for me today if he saw that. So very surprising that I won. Second win of the season. Puts me in a better position in the final four for Phoenix. So season one, that's where I am right now. In the cup, the Petty car. In trucks, my own team, and then Extreme Dirt Tour is Tony Stewart's team. So despite my qualifying lap at Michigan, I start 34th. So not a great qualifying lap for sure. I think Kyle Busch is on the pole today. Yeah. I'm not worried about who's beside him, but so the race include Chris Buescher, Kyle Busch, and Daniel Suarez. With Chris Buescher saying he likes me, he'll bump draft me whenever I am near him. And then Daniel Suarez failed pre-race inspection. There's some driver that'll drop to the rear because of, you know, faulty adjustments, you know, like the track bar, the sway bar, you name it. Especially the chassis, you know. And sometimes aerodynamic advantages. So as the green flag comes out at Michigan International Speedway, let's see if I can climb to the front. So here we go. And I dropped to the bottom of, or make a hard left on the back stretch. Tongue twister. I don't know how I was going to say it, but I just dropped that low near the apron, so that way I don't press the whole field, which, you know, will give you a DNF, I'm telling you, if you're not careful, you know. Like in this game for Heat 5 this year, if you try to hit the wall on purpose, you're just getting a DNF, like head on. Can't do that this year. And that's one of the loopholes I did last year, and that's why I completed the game quicker, you know? So, let's go on to the race. Or, move on to the race. Yep, I like Quinn Half's run, or pass me for 35th. And Daniel Suarez is right there too, and not having a great race, I'm telling you. So, here's my rear bumper camera right now, and it's facing Corey LaJoy. Okay. Yep, it's not Timmy Hill, it's Corey LaJoy. I mean, that's like one of the best onboard cameras in all of NASCAR, and it shows you the behind the scenes of what a driver goes through when he feels under pressure from behind, and if they get loose, they lose a lot of spots, I'm telling you. Especially in a track like Michigan, you know, they'll be left in the dust, I'm telling you. So, I will fast forward to the end of the race and sit back, eat some popcorn, or get a drink of water, and hopefully get back to you. And we're back. So here is the final restart for the Firekeepers Casino 400 at Michigan International Speedway. So it'll be 5 laps to go, and at the end of the race, let's see if my race car is gonna come to life and actually climb through the field like usual. So I did take four fresh tires, so this car is gonna come to me and actually pass the back markers easily. So see, I'm about to pass Justin Haley for position and also pass Timmy Hill with no problems. If they all had fresh tires, I'd be dead last, though. But otherwise, they didn't want to come in because they wanted that track position for sure. So, did you hear that thunder, guys? I live in the East. I'm in the East Coast, so one of those summer days in which rain pours very hard, so and includes the thunders. So, let's focus on the race, okay? So we're coming to 3 laps to go, and I'm up to 30th right now, and trying to pressure Brendan Gaughan and Cole Custer for position. Yep, I am up to 28th right now, passing everybody in the high lane already. And passing Ricky Stenhouse and Matt Benedetto for 26th position. And there's Austin Dillon and Bobby Carter. And I get him for 24th. Like, man, four cars in one corner? Man. That's why in this game, the physics and the, you know, that wouldn't happen in real life unless you're Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick, and Martin Truex Jr. You can pass four cars in one corner, I'm telling you. So I'm trying to battle Ryan Preece for 21st. And I will easily. Let's see if this race car will get me to the top 20. And I'm quite sure I might be able to do this. So. Uh-oh. It's the end of the race. And looks like we'll be finishing 21st. So. Speed rating at 97, not that bad. But not spectacular, of course. So. Better luck next time, you know. And basically, that's the best I ran all day, so. You better go back to the drawing board as far as, you know, make some, write some notes down of what we should have done better on our in-race adjustments. Like the wedge, or the track bar, or the air pressure, you know, like shuffle it up so the weight transfer of the cars is, you know, gets better during a long run, which is my cup of tea. And basically, you didn't miss anything from this race. Very entertaining, so. So who's the winner? Kyle Busch. And then Denny Hamlin follows him too, so. 1-2 finish, I believe. So where will I be dropped in the points standings? Ooh, man. 7 or 8. Yeah. I've had a sour luck, man. That Martinsville race and this race. Unacceptable. So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video right now, so click on that bell button if you want to subscribe for more content. Get the thumbs up button if you like the video so much. And if you found my recent video interesting, share a comment down below the description so you can comment with others and give them feedback of how you felt about it. So I'm AK Happy Corner 957. Y'all have a great day and peace out.